best known region to witness the beauty of nature of India is Western Ghats region. Unparalleled and spectacular flora and fauna, flourishing green valley and imposing mountainous regions welcomes you to the Green Globe. Yes, it is Bandipur. It is bestowed with mesmerizing natural setting and serene atmosphere. This is the land of sasya shamala. It is the land where the beauty of nature is at its best. Lush green cannabis, diverse flora and fauna, Mother Nature has blessed this place with its vast creations. Bandipur is the best known wildlife reserve situated in the Deccan Plateau, halfway down the Mysore Ooty highway. It is the part of Chamarajanagar district in Karnataka state. It is bestowed with a moderate climate and diverse geographical features. In 1898, the area was first notified as a reserve forest by the British Raj. Nalwadi, Krishnaraj, Wadeyar, the Maharaja of Mysore, declared 90 square kilometers as a game reserve in 1931. Subsequently, in 1941, 800 square kilometers is upgraded as Venugopala Swamy Wildlife Park. This vast expanse of range that stretches across 874.2 square kilometers, declared as the Bandipur National Park in 1973, out of which 690 square kilometers constituted a tiger reserve. It is one of the first 9 reserves to be brought under the Project Tiger. Today, with an extension of 1282.39 square kilometers, the park has 872.24 square kilometers, the core zone, and 82 square kilometers tourism zone, and 1 square kilometer of administrative zone. Bandipur supports a good population of endangered and vulnerable species, and it is home to over 200 species of birds. This tiger reserve is surrounded by Karnataka's Nagarhole National Park to its northwest. These are part of the Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve, India's first biosphere reserve that encompasses over 5,500 square kilometer area. It is the best stretch of habitat for elephants and tigers. The park is full of hills and valleys drenched by the rivers of Kabini, Nugu, Moyar and numerous small streams.
Bandipur is one of the oldest national park and also one of the oldest Project Tiger in India. During 1973, Government of India has notified 9 Project Tiger reserves in India. Bandipur is one among them. During 1973, our tiger population is just 11. Now, last year, 13-14, we have got 105 tigers in Bandipur National Park. In Bandipur National Park, there is no settlement inside the national park. And with the entire core area, there is no settlement. And we have got very little problems regarding man-animal conflict and also invasive species of weeds like Lantana, Eupatorium and Parthenium. And thirdly, we have got these fire incidents due to bamboo flowering. If you consider man-animal conflict, it is biggest when compared to other sanctuaries, because we have got around 1,600 elephant with us. Mainly man-animal conflict due to elephants, tigers and leopards. Rest wild boars also there, their contribution in the man-animal conflict is very less. Regarding man-animal conflict, In three sides, we have got a forest, contiguous forest area. Only in northern portion, we have got these village sites. Actually, we have got 240 kilometer length of our park boundary lies with the villages. If we consider a 10 kilometer radius from the park boundary, we have got 3 lakh human population, 2 lakh cattle population, and also 143 villages within 10 kilometer radius from the park boundary.
India has 65% of Asia's tiger population. Evaluation of the tiger's conservation status in India revealed shattering news in the early 1990s. With the discovery of large-scale poaching and trafficking for the illegal international trade in tiger parts. The huge demand for tiger bones destined for use in oriental traditional medicine outside of India and as a macho supplement is an added threat to the Indian tiger population. The Bandipur National Park has been brought under the Project Tiger since 1973 and given rigid protection. As a result, there is a tremendous improvement in the habitat and wildlife population. Therefore, there is a necessity of wildlife surveillance. Wildlife monitoring is essential for keeping track of animal movement patterns, habitat utilization, population demographics, snaring and poaching incidents and breakouts. Traditionally, anti-poaching camps personnel used for surveillance. Those guards had to report manually at the end of the duty. In addition to it, VHF radio tracking system is used for animal tracking and research. Later on, satellite tracking system has been developed. Tigers in Bandipur, a prime tiger habitat, are vulnerable to poaching. Tracking the camp activities becomes difficult due to the climatic and geographical constraints. Effective protection of this habitat calls for modernization. With the advent of technology, the wildlife conservation became much smarter with smartphone and mobile applications. One such effort is Hejje, the software which will help the entire brigade of wildlife conservation and surveillance to connect in a meaningful and soulful way.
During January and February of this year, we in the entire country we started this tiger estimation program. For that, instead of doing departmentally, we wanted to invite all the volunteers and other NGOs. In this process, we called applications. Nearly 1,000 plus applications have come, and we have selected based on their merit and their experiences in the forest area. So out of this, lot of doctors, NGOs, volunteers and techies, they have participated. During the process, we made them to camp in the anti-poaching camp. They have come across the problem of our watchers facing in the camp, and also documentation of this movement of watchers till morning, from morning till evening. It is only based on their say, that is, whatever they come to the camp and write their diary, we are depend upon their diaries. To overcome this, this techies have discussed with us and they wanted to have some suggestions. Then the dialogue went between techies and us, and they wanted to bring some change. They wanted to introduce some high-tech technology to monitor the anti-poaching camp and their movement. So ultimately, they have given some ideas to us. And they have developed one software called Hejje. It is a software based on the mobile set, their technology is so simple, and even illiterate can operate this technology. Here, the purchaser of the mobile sets and with the simple software, just by clicking the color button, it will be switch on. Once it is switch on, it will give immediately message to the concerned RFO, ACF and also concerned DFO, and we kept the main server in the headquarter. Immediately when they switch on, we will come to know the camp name, the date, time and also battery level and the GPS reading, and we can know that they are already active. And when they started their movement, it will be tracked on the Google map. And whenever they sit or waiting for some period, that will also known to me. And every 30 minutes on its own, without the operator's knowledge, it will send the SMS to us.
Hejje is a habitat tracking system. It is an indigenously developed Android-based app. The purpose of this application is to communicate and collect all the vital information of the habitat. This new mobile application is used for vigorous monitoring and better coordination of anti-poaching camp personnel at Bandipur. All the alerts and notifications from Hejje are sent out as SMS to the assigned number for the application on a real-time basis. The induction of Hejje adds a new protocol to the monitoring system and acts as a knowledge base. This application has been developed by the Key Falcon Solutions of Bangalore.
This Hejje application was developed primarily for Bandipur Tiger Reserve. And the requirements were provided by Mr. Hejje, the conservator of Bandipur Tiger Reserve. So once we got the requirement from the conservator, we had several brainstorming sessions with RFOs to freeze the requirements, and then we also took the inputs of the field staff, and also like we got to understand the taste of the field staff so that the mobile could be developed considering their education level and also ease of use. So this is how like we arrived at developing this Hejje software, and now this is successfully used in all anti-poaching camps. That is like 46 anti-poaching camps in Bandipur.
It will help coordinate foot patrolling of forest staff, apart from providing the range forest officers live updates of their respective anti-poaching patrolling activities, such as patrol time, water level in lakes, suspicious activities, tree population and forest fires. The collected information would be made available on an internal application for further analysis by the regional forest officer and assistant conservator of forests and conservator of forests.
Whereas the management would use the internal application and then get to know the information about their paths. Like this is the login page where the RFOs or the conservator or the ACFs can use to log into application. And this is the internal application. So as soon as they log in, they'll be presented with the entire forest range map. So and once the conservator just mouse over on these map, they get the complete information at what time the beat was started, at how many kilometers the patrolling happened, and also how many hours the patrolling happened. So those things will be displayed to the conservator real time. And also they can go at a range level, like for a particular range and the camp, they can drill down the reports and get to know exactly like where their camp members are. And another good thing about this is like the camp performance. So this helps to compare the patrolling efficiency between the camps and also take a corrective measures to improve the performance. We can also get the reports by range and then also see that the beats are not repeated. So when the camp members are using this using this mobile application. So every beat is recorded and any duplication beat is also alerted to the RFOs. So a range map. So the range map would be presented like this, and the camp colors, the legends mention the different camps, and this is their track path. So using this, any uncovered patrol area can be intimated to the field staff. And also whatever animal sightings the camp members do, like that is recorded on the mobile, and that will be passed to the server. And the conservator can check, like for a particular month, what animal sightings have been done at particular camp using this report. And also there is a map view wherein you can see the animals and the photos taken along with the location and the time of the photo taken. So this helps for research purpose and also the further analysis. Apart from this, there is also option for get the details based on a particular location by radius. Say suppose there was a death of an elephant, and then we want to know like what time the patrolling happened and what could be the reason for the death of it. So we can take the location of the animal death and then give the radius like 3 or 4 kilometers radius and find out. So when the patrolling happened and when the animal could have been died in that particular location. So this helps again in analysis in case of any scenarios like this. And apart from this, like the suspicious activity. So if there is any suspicious activity, like the camp members have noticed any suspicious activity, like there was a hint of fire, somebody would have camped inside the fire, or there was a tree cut, those kind of photos can be taken and immediately the message will be sent to RFOs, and further actions can be taken from that message. And with the photo, we also have the evidence of what had happened. And we also capture tree population. So if there is any special variety of the tree, so that can be tagged, and we get to know like how many trees are present, like a particular species of tree population details can be analyzed. At the same time, the herbivorous and carnivorous population can be tracked.
Data is encrypted and hence secured, and information will be accessible only to the authorized staff. At Bandipur, each anti-poaching camp has one such device. This device will help to monitor tiger movement. Even the pug marks and the animal parts can be monitored by just taking a photograph and downloading it with the GPS location. Virtual data of the habitat is available for analysis on a real-time basis. This helps to take quick actions and provide immediate solutions. Manpower efficiency is utilized to the maximum in anti-poaching camps. Hejje can also be used while patrolling in a vehicle.
The data collected is quite huge, and there is a lot of scope for research and also getting to know the different species, which is till date not recorded in form of daily task. So since the food patrolling happens on a daily basis and they sight the animals more than anybody else, so this and using the Android mobile, they can collect all this information, and this will be a kind of huge data for research. Using the reporting system, we can get to know the herbivorous and carnivorous population and how it is distributed. So and also this helps us to predict like when the animals would leave their fringes and come out. So like if there is like no herbivorous population in that particular range, then the range forest officers can be well prepared that okay, there might be chances where the animals would come out of the forest. So this also helps in man-animal conflict management.
In order to mitigate the man-animal conflict, we already excavated elephant probe trench and also installed the solar fencing. In addition to these two barriers, we also created the border road all along the EPT. still our animal will be crossing over the border, and to bring them back we have created the this anti depredation camps. Whenever our animals gone out from the forest area, our people will go and bring them back to the forest area and immediately will compensate to the concerned farmers. To do all this bringing back the animals, in addition to our permanent establishment, we have also created one special tiger protection force during 2012. Right now that special tiger protection force is also helping not only in combing the snares and also bringing the animal back to the forest area, they will be helping in crowd control and they are working like a reserved police. Because of all these barriers, we have achieved the man-animal conflict, and we have got very little incidences in recent years.
Bandipur National Park is regarded as one of the most beautiful and better managed national parks of India. This occupies a special place in the India's efforts towards eco-conservation. By adopting modern technology, it has become a role model for the rest of the wildlife conservation efforts. In this magical land, new species are still being discovered. Nature hums new rhythm every day with exotic beauty of lush green forests, rhythmically murmuring streams, chirping birds, soothing breeze, buzz of bees, playful animals enthralls the visitors.